Today we are going to talk about assignment problems. These are the kinds of problems that are generally used in all the operation research subjects, and the topic that I'm going to cover today is used for many of the organization, and the name is assignment problems. Basically, this is nothing but to find the best person for the best job. Now let's suppose there's a company who wants to appoint best salesperson for the best product. So in this kind of situation, the company has to undergo an assignment problems. Now let's see, for an assignment problem to be solved, we need to check two conditions. First, whether the given problem is into matrix form. Now matrix form is there are number of rows and number of columns. So first condition, we need to check whether the number of rows, let's say M, is equal to number of column, let's say N. So when a problem given the number of rows is equal to number of columns, that is called as balanced problem. And when the number of rows are not equal to number of columns, that is called as unbalanced problem. So in this video, we are only going to talk about type A problem. Now let's see, there's a company who wants to assign a particular module. Let's say this is a module. Module A1, A2, A3, A4. This needs to be assigned to a particular programmer. Let's say these are the programmers. Let's see N1, N2, N3, and N4. So now the task is that how it is to be carried out so that only one module has to be taken care by only one programmer. Like ek बंदा सिर्फ एक ही मॉड्यूल को हैंडल करेगा. द असाइनमेंट प्रॉब्लम, द जिस्ट ऑफ द असाइनमेंट प्रॉब्लम इज दैट ओनली वन मॉड्यूल विल बी असाइन टू ओनली वन प्रोग्रामर्स, एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द लीस्ट कॉस्ट बाय विच वी कैन डू इट. नाउ सपोज दिस इज 8, 26, 17, 18, 17, 11. दीज आर द टाइम आवर्स दैट आर टेकन बाय ऑल द प्रोग्रामर्स टू कंप्लीट अ पर्टिकुलर मॉड्यूल. So now there are two types of problems that can be asked in assignment. That is, either it should be minimization of the cost or maximization of the profit. So here in this particular problem, they are asking us to find out the minimum time required to complete this assignment problem. So in order to solve the assignment problem, there are various steps that we need to undergo. The very first step is that row reduction. That is, we have to identify the minimum element in the row and subtract from all the other elements. In this problem, if you go, you will see that the minimum element is 8. So what we are going to do, we are going to subtract 8 from all the remaining elements. So if I have to subtract 8 from 8, it will be 0, then 26, that will be 18, 17, that will be 9. Then I got 3. Similarly, in the row 2, I will identify the smallest element, that is 4. So I will subtract from all the other row elements. So the answer will be 9, 24, 0, 22. Again, for the third row, what I'll do, I'll identify the smallest element, that is 15. So I'll subtract 15 from rest of the elements. So my answers will be 23, 4, 3, 0. Again, same operation for the row 4, that is the smallest element is 10. So I'm going to subtract 10 from all the remaining elements. So my answer will be 9, 16, 14, 0. The thing that we have done recently is called row reduction. To solve the assignment problems, the very first thing that we need to do is the row reduction. Row reduction, I'll repeat once again. We have to identify the smallest element in each row. These are all A1, A2, A3, A4 are all rows. So no matter whether it's a 4x4 matrix as given here, or it is a 5x5 matrix or a 6x6 matrix, we are going to solve the row 1 first. Then we will go to row 2, row 3, and likewise. So very first step is to perform row reduction, wherein we identify the smallest element and we subtract it from the rest of the elements. After performing the row reduction, we need to check whether are we getting a zero element in each of the columns. Like this is column C1, we got 1 0. In column 2, we do not have any 0. In third column we do have 1 0, and here there are 2 0. So when there is see, we have performed row reduction, but we have to check column wise whether there is a zero presence in all the columns. And if it is not there, we have to undergo column reduction. Column reduction is very much similar to what we have done with row reduction. Only thing is that instead of row, now we are going to check whether the smallest element in any column is to be subtracted from the rest of the elements. Now here the zero is the smallest element, so this column will not have any changes. Here we got the smallest element is 4. See, check column wise. So we got 4 is the smallest element. So after reduction, we got 14, then we got 20, then we got 0, and we got 12. Similarly, in this column, we got 0 is the smallest element, so there will not be much changes, and this also remains the same. So in order to solve the assignment problem, we have to first do row reduction and then we have to do column reduction. Once we are sure that we have at least 1 0 in each of the column, we are ready to perform the third step. See, row reduction is done, column reduction is done. Now draw the minimum lines to cover all the zeros. It is very simple. What we have to do, we have to cover these zeros. Like this is 1 0, there is 1 0. So what we have to do, we have to draw straight lines covering all the zeros, and we have to ensure that we are using the minimum lines. So let's go row wise. You know, I'll go row first and then I'll check column in the second part. So if I'll put a single line here, I'm able to cut 1 0. If I put single line here, I'll able to cut 1 0. Similarly here, if I put a straight line, I am able to cut 2 zeros. So I'll put a straight line here. Similarly, if I'll go for this again, this 1 0 is there. So now I can again perform the operation column wise also. So if I go column wise also, see again 1 0 2 0. So this is a problem where we got only 2 zeros. There are 5 by 5 matrix, and we might get 3 zeros in a row or 4 zeros in a column. So accordingly we have to choose. So this is one of the simplest problem. So again, I will repeat once again. I will go row 1, row 2, row 3, no matter whichever row I delete, I only going to cover only single zero. So I'll do simple 1, 2 and 3. So now this is my line 1, line 2, line 3 and line 4. So now it's time to check for the next condition, and that what it says that if the number of lines drawn is equal to number of rows is equal to number of columns, we have reached the optimality. So that means we have reached to the optimum reductions that are possible with the given problem. So now what I'll do, I'll rewrite the achieved numbers like 9, 23, 9, again 14, 20, 0, 12, 9, 0, 3, 14, 3, 22, 0 and 0. Now this is the third step of the problem, that is where we need to actually assign the zeros. Now there are three golden rules for this. Always go with the row first. Choose a row or column having a single zero. Here you need to give a priority to identify the row or column which has only single zero, and then once that is found, we need to strike out the corresponding rows and columns. Let's see on practical ground. See, if I go row 1, then what I can see is that, you know, here I get the first 0. So what I'll do, I will draw this square on this 0. See, if suppose there would have been 0 here, so what I've done, once this row is assigned, this could have been crossed. Again, if I go with this, I'll find that this is only single zero, so I will assign this. Again, iske column side mein, if we got 1 0 or more than 1 0, so we could have cut it. Then here is a third row, but we got 2 zeros, so we will first try to identify the rows or columns which has single zero. So I will skip row third, then I'll go for row 4. Again, I got this. So here you can see this. So this is row. I found a 0 here, so what I'll do, in that adjacent 1 0 is there, so I'll cut it. Okay, So now all rows are over, so I'll go column wise. Again, this is already allotted. If I go this column wise, I got this 0. So now all the rows and columns are done. So I got these 1, 2, 3, 4 are my optimal solution. See, I'll repeat what I've done. See, this is an assignment stage wherein I need to cover up. See, in this stage we got all the zeros that to be covered with single lines. Then we need to measure all the lines are equal to number of rows is equal to number of columns. Lines is equal to m is equal to n. This is in condition of optimality. Once that is achieved, I will go to next step where I'm going to assign the number of zeros. So I will identify the number of rows or columns where I get only single zero. मान लीजिए यहाँ नहीं मिलता तो आई वुड हैव गॉन टू दिस रो, इफ नॉट देन दिस रो, इफ नॉट देन दिस रो. आई वुड हैव कंटिन्यूड विद कॉलम्स आल्सो टिल द टाइम आई गेट अ सिंगल जीरो इन अ सिंगल रो और कॉलम. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड क्रूशल. एंड वंस यू असाइन दैट जीरो टू अ पर्टिकुलर पोर्शन, मेक श्योर दैट उसका एडजेसेंट, इफ सपोज दिस इज असाइन रो वाइज देन कॉलम वाइज वट एवर द जीरोज आर देयर दैट शुड बी इलिमिनेटेड. वट यू हैव डन हियर आल्सो, सी हियर आई फाउंड द जीरो दिस, then I assigned it and the corresponding all the column zeros I have eliminated. So this is you need to do. Now what you have to do, you have to check these positions in the original problem. If I go here, this is the original problem. So my assigned value is 0. So my original problem is 8. So I will add 8 plus this position in the original problem is 19. So I am going to sum up 19. That this position and the original problem is 4. So I will assign 4 to this. And this position and the original problem is 10. So if I'm going to calculate this, the answer will be 41. So my optimal solution is equal to 41 hours. So in order to complete the given problem with the minimum efforts, we need to do with 41 hours. This is called assignment problem. And for the assignment problems where it is not a balanced problem, please see my next video lecture. Thank you so much.